Howdy, everybody. I am Kolik, and this is Summoner's War. We're back again with our Getting Started videos, and today, well, you know, at the moment, I am running a double XP pack that was given to us by finishing Tamar Desert, I think it was, or maybe it was Varagoth Ruins. Anyway, so been running that, and my guy is level 30 for Water Magic Knight, and here comes the next question. Question it really comes is this. So, all right, had enough guys to fodder up two of these Rainbow Mon, and you're given a couple more. Okay, who do I sacrifice? And this is actually a really good question. All right, the easy way to do it is if you come over here and you can see these little gold circles in the lower left corner. These gold little circles indicate that it's a fusion monster. If you hold, you know, the button down on that, your finger down, and you pop this, it'll give you the fuse menu. And this fuse menu will tell you exactly where this guy is. He's highlighted, what monster he fuses into, and what monster that fuses into. Now, some of these guys are used twice, so it's important to realize that. And some of them are only used once for the 4 stars, so you may want 2 copies of stuff. Okay, but the most important fusion that we want is Varimos. And Varimos says that right now the only person we have for it is the Water Harpy. So we want to save the Water Harpy for sure. Second most important fusion is Beretta. Now it shows I have 2 different fusions available. Well, 2 different pieces of the Beretta fusion available. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to save both of them too. So I don't want to use the Fire Marshal Cat or the Fire Serpent. And I don't want to use the Water Harpy. So let's go see what other choices we have. Okay, so I don't want to sacrifice any Light and Dark. We already went over that. We want to save them in case of buffs. So we'll go ahead and sacrifice him. And then, let's see. You know, I can sacrifice him. And I can sacrifice him or her. Okay. Now, I mean, you know, technically, I'd like to get Megan, just give me skills for Megan. I don't have Megan yet. I need to go ahead and keep progressing. So I'm going to go ahead and level evolve this Rainbow Mon. Now, the problem is I don't have anything else. So now, I'm going to have to go through and start leveling up these 2 stars to become 3 stars. I went ahead and summoned all my unknown scrolls. So I have a few things to play around with. Now, if I went and evolved, farmed all the essences up, would that make my guy stronger? Yeah, it would. Should I do that today? I don't know. It's a really good question. If you can't farm at least, say, B4, then it gets, you know, a lot more expensive to time-wise and in resource, energy-wise, to try and farm up this stuff to evolve it. And when I tried to farm magic before, I was kind of with the failure because I don't have a perch. And he puts up an invulnerability buff, which means I have to, I don't have a heal, right? Because I went without a heal. So that's a bit difficult for this team at the moment because I just don't hit quite hard enough yet either. So I think that go ahead and concentrate on the XP pack first is a pretty good idea. It's not going to hurt you in the long run. Could I sacrifice this succubus? Yes, I could. And make him 5-star immediately. But I might, you know, again, come to us, might buff this unit. You never know. It's a really good question. I mean, you could get rid of it. But, you know, and as I said, you're risking that they buff the unit and you screw yourself, essentially. So I would try and not give in to the temptation, particularly since you're already got an XP pack farming running. I mean, you don't really need it. Now, I do have the L&D. I used my friends and went up and killed that boss, so I have an L&D scroll. So I figured I'd go ahead and summon that. Maybe we'll get something exciting, but probably not. No lightning, but, you know, still can be pretty good. We'll see what we get. The Light Imp Champion. So, this guy He's got like a little recovery ability. He gains it to gains XP and counterattacking. And yeah, generally speaking, you want to keep a counterattack and with some sort of guy that's going to give a good debuff. This guy's not amazing for that. So, plus he's got to be immune to attack, really do damage, which means he can't take many hits. So if he gets hit, it's non-synergistic. It essentially you're saying you want to get hit, but you can't take too many hits. So you get a buff, and maybe you dot him, but does the dot really win you the fight? And then it's just kind of weird and doesn't really. It's like yeah. Yeah, and the problem is again, just it's not synergistic. Could Contuos buff that and make that interesting? Yeah, sure. How about buffing his own defense? He's a defense type unit on his second skill, or maybe they change one of his third attack, say, to so it scales with defense, and then you could then he could be a defensive oriented unit with gives you counter attacking and. Dark units would naturally attack him, and then he would dot them back, increase his attack power. There's definitely ways that they could change that and make it interesting. The example of it is Sin. I mean, Sin just went over and got like three buffs in three in one patch. They buffed the crit, the dead stun rate on the first skill. They buffed the second skill so that it gives you a chance to give you an additional turn immediately. And then they also buffed, they changed the passive and added the ability that you can't be defense broken. All in one patch, okay? Rakan is another great unit. The Nat 5 used to be a very poor unit. And they buffed him and it didn't work. And they buffed him and it didn't work. And they gave him a counter-attacking ability. And he counterattacks with his third. And that made him pretty good. Because he is so hard to kill when he can randomly shoot out his third powerful ability onto a monster whenever they attack him. You never know. Little buffs, sometimes they can do things, but you don't know when they're going to do that little big buff or revamp on that unit and decide, I'm going to make this guy interesting. And to be honest, I would think that the Imp Champions. If I had to pick a character type, that would probably be might be done. Imp Champions are definitely one that could be done because the only one that's really interesting is the water one, because he's actually pretty decent in dragons. All right. Anyway, we didn't get anything, super stellarly useful, but yeah, we're gonna go on from here and see what we can do. Now I know you don't have enough much energy as I do. One thing that you should do. Is use up your energy. Let's see how to do this. You'll notice I have a lot of things uncollected down here. These give XP. What you would like to do is run your energy down to so where you're close to out of experience and your arenas, and then collect these to push you over to maximize your energy efficiency. Does it really matter too much in the long haul? When I was leveling up the first time. It didn't matter so much, okay? And your energy regen is not the greatest at the moment. You can improve it from it via glory buildings, but you get free energy if you log in like 3 times a day. Even if you do nothing, you just log in, it puts it into your inbox, and then you can log out, and close the app and go back to do whatever you're doing and save those up. They save up for 7 days, which is great. You can just time them a whole bunch of them. Up with a double XP pack or someday that you want to go farming and knock them all out. Okay? So yeah, that's pretty good. Now where I've been farming, I've went ahead and I've been farming over here in Varagoth's Ruins. I want to go for a stage that's all fire because I am all water. Well, I'm not all water, but it makes this guy more effective. Okay, and so now I'm gonna be like, I need level up some 2 stars. I mean, that's what it comes down to. I need to level up some 2 stars. So we're going to go ahead and click these three guys off. And we're going to level up this guy. He's got a little bit of heal, so that's okay. And we're going to just level up a few 2 stars right away. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and I want to do some. I'm going to get fire elementals from here. I want these guys to die pretty fast, so I'm just going to go ahead and put those guys up there like that. Okay. Think this guy actually has a leader skill because he's a. There we go. I increased the crit rate. My fodder monster is increasing my crit rate. You can look for that. Those guys are kind of cute. They're obviously not very good units or anything, but 10% crit rate's 10% crit rate. And don't quite kill them all on that skill. Let's see if I can if I can get my unit up here. It's high enough to go ahead and solo this as a farmer. I mean, obviously he's stronger simply because he's level max level now. This is level 30. Looks like I'm doing okay. Most of the unitary units are dead. Yep, most of their units are dead. Of course, I'm heal blocked to my heal, but it doesn't matter. Okay. 47 second time. And you don't need anything special at all to be able to do this. And we're just going to sell all those runes and replay for a few times. So, leveling to 2 stars. It's not quite double, but leveling 1 2-star to 20. And leveling 1 3-star to 25. Leveling 1 3-star to 25 is slightly more than double doing 2 stars. So if you say I need to level up a 3-star to level 25 and some 2 stars to level 20, you could level up at 1 3-star and 2 2-stars, and then you could put in 2 new 2-stars once those guys hit level 20. And the last guy will. And when those guys second set of 2 stars hit level 20, the third the 3-star guy will be about ready. It's like you need like one run to finish off him hitting 3-star level 35. I mean, 25 level 35. That'd be pretty cool. Okay, and this is about true for all of them. So going up, if you want to level up a 4-star. You can level up basically 4 other 3 stars to level 25 when you get just to take the time that it takes up to level 1 star to level 30, and so on. You know, 1 level 5 star, you can level up 4 level 4 stars to level 30. Now, you're not going to need to level up a whole bunch of 3 stars, or 4 stars to level 30. If you're going ahead and doing, you join a guild and you start doing some guild wars. Now, most guild wars are not going to take you until you have some sort of at least a couple units that you can use to bring in, and because they want to win the war, and they're going to be mostly like farming guilds, so they're going to put one monster on defense, probably a crappy monster, and you'll just gain some free points. You're aiming for these the rainbow mod for free, which is awesome. You get ones a week. And of course, going for the Ifrit summoning pieces. That's the big deal. The Ifrits are nat fives that you get, and you can get one at random. There's a water, a fire, and a wind. And because they're nat fives, I guess? I don't know. They're all actually useful. It just depends on what you want to do with them. Theomars is a ridiculously good attacker. That's the water. Tessarion shuts down passives. That is really good in PvP. He can be a good tank. And the guy that no one's can pronounce his name, they can pronounce. I call him Amir, okay? But it's like Akamir. I don't know. Sue me, okay? He's got this interesting ability where his damage scales with the number of debuffs his opponents have, and it's an AoE. So you run like a debuff heavy team, and he does more and more damage, and it scales pretty well, actually. And you can build an entire team, an arena offense, which is called a wombo team, where you just wombo and kill them all in one hit, essentially. And that's what he is pretty good at, that role. He does pretty good damage. Unfortunately, it requires other units to make it really useful, but he does have an AoE stun, which makes him has two AoEs, and that makes him potential like a spare candidate for entry TOA kind of deal. He doesn't have a ton of debuffs; he does have that stun, but he doesn't have like a ton of debuffs like some other units. But I use Varimos all the time in TOA, and Varimos is the dark Ifrit, and really and truthfully, the wind guy might actually be better. I mean, he's got the same stun, he doesn't have a cleanse, but Varimos I only usually use for cleanse too, and doing damage according to debuffs. I'm thinking about it. Maybe I should be using him instead of Varimos. Wow, there goes my Devil Mons. Incidentally, again, need to do arena matches so that you can get those Devil Mons because we're trying to get Varimos. Varimos is very useful for starting out. For both, he's great in giants. He's great in dragons. He's great in TOA. He's useful in PvP. So he's useful in a lot of the PvE content. Not raids, not necro, okay? But he's useful in a lot of the PvP content, and then he's useful again in PvP too. He's got an AoE stun, he cleanses people, he's got a dot, he's got an HP leader skill. It's pretty sweet all around. So that's the first guy. That's why we're so interested in him. He's a well-rounded unit that is very useful at the late and early game and later in the game. Now, late game, you don't see a lot of people using Varimos, but I have seen some trap defenses where people put really good runes on Varimos, and Varimos runs on this rune called Nemesis, where he basically can he gets damaged, and then he can cut in and smack down the opponent's team and prevent them from doing anything because of his stun. And does it work? Yeah, it works. People think that they can wombo it, and they end up losing. Well, I mean, if you can trap people into that, it's pretty cool, actually. Of course, it's not going to be 100%. No defense is 100%. Don't expect a defense to be 100%. Heck, if you can get a defense that wins 50% of the time, that's a pretty good defense, actually, as it turns out. If you can get one that can, oh, 3-star HP percent. I'll keep that one, actually. You can get that just that little 50%. Actually, pretty good. Pretty good. He's also not too bad in World Arena, because you can time up what kind of stun you want him. So he's actually a little bit worse there than on defense, in my opinion, in normal arena. But hey, we'll see. Maybe we will. I don't know. You never know how the units are going to fall. And that's the kind of thing that's cool in Summoner's War. And nobody's entry experience is different. Well, nobody's entry experience is different. Nobody's entry experience is the same, okay? Do I have amazing units? Have I pulled anything really sweet? No. Okay? But I have added in all these cool things where you get in a nice farmer, they give it to you for free, and you don't really have to do a lot of farming to go ahead and get him going. I mean, here, we've been just talking for a few minutes now, and it's already these guys are level 10. Now, of course, it's not halfway, okay? Halfway is about, I would say 13. And I haven't used all my friends up for today, but I've used quite a few that I kind of hold. Now, if you can get more friends, I mean, don't get me wrong, friends are amazing, especially for this. Okay, you could, if you get more friends, let's say you get up, and we're talking high level friends. One option is like level 50 friends that have a good farmer for a particular area. Okay. And let me show you an example of what I'm talking about here. So if you go and you can, it's best to use up your friends when you can. And especially at low level, it gives you a huge advantage. Let me give you an example here. So Hydini Ruins, a very common stage for people who want to farm in Hydini Ruins is stage 5. It's all water. Every monster is water in the entire fight. Okay? Well, if I use friends up, let's say I have 40 friends, okay? And one day I could push, okay, all the way through hard. That's 7 friends. And then go into hell. Can't select it yet. Go to 5. It's 12 friends. Alright. I have 28 friends left. Alright. Now, I am getting, I don't know, let's go look on what kind of experience I'm getting here again. But if you're using a friend to farm in that level, you gain, I think, something like 3,800 experience per monster with taking 3 monsters. That seems about right. I think it's like 14,000 experience or thereabouts if you bring one monster in with a friend. That's a really rapid way to level. Of course, that's with double XP running. Can't forget that notation. I mean, that is actually really important to note. But that's a really lot of amount of experience. I don't know what I'm going to... you probably have noticed what I'm getting here. I haven't been paying too much attention. But wow, that's really a rapid way to level up. Then if you have 40 friends, okay, and obviously you want a wind or a water monster for this area, that's what you're looking for. A guy usually is an attacker that can do that kind of damage. So at double XP, I'd be earning basically over 3 times as much. 3 times as much XP per monster there. That's pretty cool. Now, on these double XP packages, some are 12 hours, 24, 48, 6. They have little different amounts. If your time zone matches up with your server such that you are awake when the server resets, it's nice to have your double XP packages, especially if you're just going to use friends, or either or, to cross over that dateline. Say, like, if I'm in the U.S., and the server reset for me is 2 a.m. in the morning. Well, popping a double XP pack at, say, 9 o'clock at night, burning through all my friends, and then coming back in the morning and burning through all my friends again is actually pretty efficient. Because your friend doesn't take up that XP, you're actually gaining an extra 30% XP. Now, if you want to level up a unit in particular real fast, this is excellent because you can focus all the XP on that one guy. Basically, you're getting 4x his type XP because your guy isn't sucking down the XP, your farmer unit. And that's pretty efficient for being able to get one guy in particular up. Of course, when you need a lot of XP just in general, and it's not so useful to think about that way because you really do need to go ahead and just farm for as many hours as you can to gain that XP up. But it is a useful plan to go ahead and do it that way. Now, this is a 24-hour pack, so technically I will be able to, if I get up early in the morning, to go ahead and use all these friends that I've gotten together. Now, I don't have 40 friends yet. I haven't really tried. But I definitely suggest if you're starting out that you should. Okay? It's just the friends are amazing. You get to clear all this content. You get to get the rune sets for free. You get your everything faster. There's even more rune sets out there that are free. I should be... as I said, I pushed my... guy up. And once I get this guy, the fodder up, I probably will be going back and trying to get maybe some friends and push throughout the day to see how many dungeons I can unlock. I kind of like that idea, which I just thought about, of pushing that particular level up to get that massive XP farm, because effectively being able to do that there, I'm earning more than the double XP package works for myself. And it's substantially more because he doesn't count as XP. So as long as I don't have to level up my farmer, which of course I do want to level up my farmer, but I mean, as long as if I don't have to level up my farmer because he's already max level, I'm earning, you know, really four times as much, not three times, it's just four times because of that, I think. You know, it could be three times, but it's just that's a really great amount of XP. All right, well, now, talked about the fusion monsters, talked about leveling up techniques, doing this kind of stuff. Let's see, what else do we want to talk about? Well, all right. What are the important events every month? All right, let me talk you through the important events. The important events are the first weekend of every month, and it's always the first weekend of every month, unless the first is a Friday, I think they said. It's rune-free removal day. You can move all your runes for free. You can move them around. You can do whatever you want with them. At this stage in the game, yeah, sure, it's useful. If you want to say you get to the next set, you want to put it on the Magic Knight, you move this current set onto a different character, it's useful. All right, we're good. But other than that, you're not going to be playing with a whole bunch of runes yet because we simply don't have access. We're trying to farm up the guys so that we can really gain access to it. So, yeah, of course, this is only day two on this account, okay? Yes, this is only day two. And we're doing pretty strong, you know, on this account. So, yeah, it's going pretty good. Now, you're like, okay, I want a healer, Colic. Well, let me tell you. This little guy here, the Water Howl, not a bad healer, okay? Should you evolve him, right? Should you awaken him? Should you make him 5-star? No. He is a respectable healer right now at the moment. And, you know, it doesn't cost you anything to level him to 4-star or make him a 5-star level 1 and keep him there as Cthulhu. He's a respectable little healer. But he's a respectable little healer. Okay? Now, in comparison, Konamiya, the Water Garuda, is a respectable little healer too, but also can stun, and also can grant attack power and fill up the attack bar, much like our Light Garuda here. And Konamiya is actually pretty useful because of the ability to have one guy go, and then Kona go, okay? And then Kona gives the turn back to the first guy. So this first guy really gets to go twice in a row, essentially giving him a proc from his violent runes. That's really useful. Alternatively, Kona can make a slow guy go next. So instead of, you know, waiting around for that guy to go, you can do that. Or Kona can make himself go next, okay? Which gives him the attack buff, and then he can try and stun, but it takes one turn off his healing and cleansing ability, which is actually really good, okay? Especially when Kona's on violent, I have seen Kona just go, go, go. I mean, take 5 turns in a row, pump out 2 heals, stun 2 people, you know, it happens. It can happen. And it does happen. As compared to the Water Howl, the Water Howl's like, I healed this turn. You know, if you're lucky, I'll heal again. And if you're lucky again, then I'll shoot somebody for negligible damage. Exciting. Anyway, so the Water Howl, It's useful to go ahead and pair with your farmer when you're leveling, and level him up, make him one of your guys that you're gonna fodder away at higher levels. You get plenty of them because you get plenty of 2 stars. So they're pretty useful in general because of that, particularly if you're fighting like a fire team with your water magic knights. They're not gonna be targeted first anyway. Yeah, they're not bad. They're not amazing. Okay, don't get me wrong. They're just not amazing, and that's the difference. When I originally was leveling up, I leveled him to 5-star max level. Total waste. Total waste. It was a waste to get all that experience to him, and he couldn't cut it. Eventually, at the higher end, you're gonna be taking a lot of damage, pretty fast, and 15% heal is just not good enough. Okay, by itself, it's the attack bar boost and attack buff that Kona gives. That's actually a really important point. Not his healing and cleansing, though the healing and cleansing can be really useful with the right team, but it's that little buff that he can give that's actually important. So, what other good farmer units? Well, of course, you get some F5 farmer units, then hey, you're great. GG, you won the game. Wait, no, you didn't. No, fuck that. You don't win the game for that. Oh my gosh. Did I tell it to go to sleep or something? All right, guys. Well, that was talented. Hit the keyboard, make it go to sleep. Oh well. All right, guys. Well. Let's see. Let's move this off screen so you can't really see what's going on. I can type in my nice password. Right. Oh, it doesn't like that. Oh, that's what happened. It doesn't like my number pad. Okay, let's try this again. Fail. 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 When YouTubers fail. Let's see if I can get this centered again. I really didn't want to have little buttons on there, guys. Alrighty. Oh, looks pretty good. So. Where was I before I screwed everything up? You could edit this out. But screw it, I'm leaving it in. Y'all need a laugh. Anyway, so we're doing pretty good here with the water magic knight. I gotta be careful hitting the keyboard. mean, long term, water magic knight, team my 6th arm. If it lets you take the next difficulty on, then maybe the answer should be sure, of course. And that can make you more efficient. But you do have your friends, and you do have that extra experience pack, which I was just talking about, the extra experience way that you can use all your friends in this harder difficulty that you can't handle, And you can get a lot of extra experience for free that way. Do you need to make him 6-star because of that? Wow, that's a really good question. I don't know the answer because, to be honest, your problem is not usually this guy, it's going to be runes. All right, now giants, something about giants and dragons and necro, which is important to note, is I all have a chance to drop a mystical scroll, which could give you better units, obviously. And the default has to be at least a 3-star, can be a 4-star, 5-star. 5 stars are like 1 in 200. 4 stars should be like 10% chance, but it might be slightly lower. You'll get streaky. I've done 80 summons and gotten 2, and I've done 12 summons and gotten 5. It'll end up being streaky. Don't get too upset about it. You basically have to learn to deal with it. Anyway, what I was going for was that the giants have a fixed chance to drop mystical scroll, regardless of level. So if you're farming for runes, Giants is a pretty place to go, pretty nice place to go, because one, you can get a good chunk of unknown scrolls, two, you can get higher power runes than you normally can, and three, it can give you those mystical scrolls, and also it can give you a 3-star rainbow mon. I think that doesn't kick into a higher level, but you can get 2-star rainbow mon, which is effectively what I'm making here by ruining these guys, leveling these guys up. And it's actually a really effective place to go and farm. In particular, you need good runes. You're going to need a lot of good runes. You can see just the power of the runes that the Water Magic Knight has gotten. And yeah, you're going to need another set in this. Now, is it your first goal to go and farm giants yet? No, I think your first goal should be to get those free rune sets that I've just gotten. They give you a huge kickstart. Oh, I'll take that, sure. And yeah, you can see a bunch of progression. Now, I'm going to go and very shortly, I'm going to try and find some more friends here on this account. And then I'm going to try and push through some levels and see if I can find me some more runes that they're going to give me for free, because I know they're out there somewhere. We just got to find out where. Now, maybe it's the area after Feymont. We'll take a quick look at that after this run and see if what that gives. I haven't taken a look at that yet. See, because when they introduced these to me, I didn't have this stuff yet. Then I had all the areas already complete, so they just, you know, handed them all to me. Just like, here you go. They're like, oh, okay, thanks for the free rune sets, but I got 6-star runes, so I really didn't need them. No, it's just like, all right, I got some more trash to run. They gave me some mana. That's what I said. All right. But these have been really useful at low levels. So let's go take a look at the world map and Aiden Forest. Aha! So we're going to get a ticket where we get 4-star purple rune packs. And we can achieve it by clearing him. Okay, so this is probably where you want to focus your friends on next, is clearing this area. I'm going to guess that one of two of these areas also gives a free rune set. That would be awesome. No, this area's never been opened, though. And there's only 4 left. I think after we clear Churika, we got the world boss might appear. We'll see about that. And the world boss is kind of random, but he's pretty useful. Unfortunately, we're just not going to have enough units to really do a whole lot on him. In fact, you need a minimum of level 30, I think, to enter for any unit. The unit has to be level 30 to enter. So we have one. We have one unit that can enter the world boss. That's kind of crazy when you think about it. But, yeah. All right, guys. Well, I've done some arena wings, and I farmed up a few glory points. Anyway, I hope you kind of enjoyed this progression series and seeing what we're doing. And, you know, I'm making a few mistakes too, but really, truthfully, these free rune sets are just so awesome. They're the first things I would push for, even before trying to, you know, they're going to give you a rune set, it looks like, that can help you with getting to giants, so that's pretty cool. And which monsters you save, the ones that are fusionable, the ones that you're going for the first fusion, and you know, how to level up your stuff. Anyway, I'll talk to you again soon, and you have a good day. This is Kolik signing out.